Hey couples, if you're married, then you need to learn a really important F word. The word is forgiveness. In this video, we're going to talk about the healing power of forgiveness, whether you're overcoming a small offense or whether you're overcoming a major offense like an affair in your marriage. We talked in a previous video about how in marriage, if you're the offender, if you've stepped out on your marriage and done something really horrible, you need to take these five steps, own up and seek counsel and have a talk and be humble and work hard to earn trust back. But if you're the spouse who's been offended, it's important for you to take these five steps on the right side of this image. And the most important one is to extend forgiveness. Because here's the truth, bitterness is a cancer that will kill you first, and then it'll grieve the whole family.
This is why forgiveness is so important, because when we don't forgive, we're bitter, we're resentful. And really, when you think about it, when I'm bitter and resentful, I'm just storing up stuff in my own heart. It's killing me. I'm just obsessing over it in my thoughts. I'm getting more and more angry. I'm lashing out even at other people because I'm just so upset and hurt in my bitterness and frustration about what's happened. The forgiveness piece is what allows us to start freeing us from that cage of bitterness and actually doing something with those emotions that we have, because it's not like you're not allowed to be hurt and angry. But the problem is when we don't forgive and we hang on to things, it's like we're just swallowing that bitter pill and it's a cancer that's eating away at us and it's not having any benefit or any effect on our spouse or on the marriage.
And so forgiveness really is like a miracle pill that will move your marriage past a trust-shattering mistake. And maybe that mistake was an infidelity, a physical or an emotional affair, or maybe it was something a little bit less serious, but still shattering to that foundational trust that you should have in your marriage.
The miracle piece of forgiveness is really you giving room for your spouse to start to earn your trust. Right? That if they've made a mistake and they've betrayed you in some way, big or small, your ability to forgive is saying, you know what? I'm going to let you have some room here, some runway to go on here to start earning my trust. And I'm going to allow you the opportunities to do that. And I'm going to accept that as I see you being trustworthy. I'm going to say, okay, that's good. You're making some ground back. Rather than if we stay in our bitterness and our unforgiveness, we're just constantly punishing our spouse and holding over their head. And it really is just kind of like there's no chance for any movement in a positive direction because you're just constantly putting them under the thumb, which honestly is hard, I know, because when you're hurt, it just seems like that's exactly what you want to do. But if you're able to put the shoe on the other foot and recognize if you're the one that made a mistake, how would you want your spouse to respond to you? Would you want them to hold it over your head and remind you every day and punish you every day and say you're not worthy and you could never make this up to me? Or do you want them to say, you know what? You hurt me, but I'm going to give you room to earn my trust back. That's where the forgiveness really is, that miracle pill. It's giving your spouse room to start earning your trust and that you give them the opportunities to do that.
This is where there's a difference between trust and forgiveness in marriage. See, extending trust is reactive, but extending forgiveness is proactive.
People sometimes confuse these two things, that they're one and the same, and they aren't. At the core, trust is something that is a reactionary response. As you see someone being trustworthy, you trust them. If you see them being not trustworthy, then you should be wise to say, I'm not going to give you my trust. But forgiveness is different. Forgiveness is a gift. Forgiveness is something that you can extend to someone even if they haven't asked for it, and certainly if they don't even deserve it. But so it's you choosing to say, I choose to forgive you like a gift. Forgiveness is a proactive response. It's not given only when your spouse asks for it or has even earned it or deserved it. It's just a gift that you give them in order to start building trust in the relationship.
There's a passage in the Bible that really summarizes this concept really well. It's in the book of Colossians, chapter 3. It says there to make allowance for each other's faults and forgive anyone who offends you. And here's the reason. It's because the Lord forgave you. So you must forgive others.
This can be hard to remember when we've been offended or wounded or betrayed in a major way by our spouse. And it's easy for us to be in that position of just focusing on the terrible mistakes that our spouse made. But we can lose sight of the fact that we too make mistakes, that we too are not perfect, that we have wounded and hurt people in our life as well. And so when our mindset for forgiveness, right, that proactive gift is, I've been forgiven. Jesus didn't hold my sin over my head. He's not punishing and reminding me every day of everything that I've ever done. I need to have that same heart of forgiveness that Jesus has for me and my brokenness. I need to have that for my spouse and their brokenness.
The truth is that forgiveness has had a powerful impact on your life if you're a follower of Jesus. And so in your marriage, you can see the same thing. You can experience the healing power of forgiveness.